Welcome back, lovely audience. In this episode, I'm going to talk to you about 5 GPUs that are actually available for you to mine with profitably today. So the RTX 3080 hit the streets, or at least supposedly hit the streets. It hit websites and was instantly snatched up by bots for flippers and resellers. Let's take a look at all the different models that are available. There are different models from Asus, different models from Colorful, MTech, EVGA, Gainword, Galax, which is kind of an off-brand, but available in some territories, Gigabyte, which we're more familiar with here in the United States, Inno3D, a popular brand that does create some mining editions, but just not yet. MSI, of course, and then Pallet at PNY Zotac, the usual suspects. So many different models that will hit the streets eventually, but that we kind of missed out on here because of those insta-buys from flippers. Let's take a look at the current state of GPU sales here on Amazon. And this is just one data point that helps us to figure out whether or not anything is actually available. This is the NVIDIA store on Amazon. And when we look for the GeForce RTX 3000 series 3080 within the NVIDIA store on Amazon, we see, there's a PNY available for $5,000. The rest are currently unavailable. That's unreal. But somebody apparently is willing to pay $5,000 or charge $5,000. Let's take a look on eBay. And I'm going to quickly look up RTX 3080. I'll do this live so you can see exactly what the results are. And that loads up. First off, I want you to see at the very bottom of the page, what I have selected is completed items. I always search for completed sales to make sure that I don't get false positives from any kind of a sale that was, you know, still in process or maybe will be taken down by eBay. But if somebody's paid $1,149, so $1,150 for a Zotac. Somebody paid $1,650 for the Founders Edition. My gosh. Somebody paid $1,400 for a Gigabyte. Somebody paid $1,500 for a PNY, Epic X RGB. People have paid $1,599 for the Founders Edition. Over $1,000 for a pre-order of the Founders Edition. What? Unreal. They might not even have it in hand. You see right here, the price just keeps going up. So to revisit the GPU spreadsheet right on the data tab, I think my initial assumption that it would be closer to $950, incorrect. I feel very confident in putting it at $1,000 for the base price because that's the minimum that somebody would pay for this card today. It's really bad news, guys, and I'm sorry to be the one to deliver those kinds of bad news, but that's the current state of obtaining the RTX 3080. And for mining, well, that's kind of a letdown. However, it's not all bad news. On YouTube, Easy Crypto went out of their way to publish their findings of the 3080. So kudos, guys. Thank you so much for publishing these. But for the RTX 3080 hash rates, they have shown that they can sustainably do 100 mega hashes per second. However, the power consumption is not what I expected, and it might not be what you expected either. That's at 250 watts. Boo. So cut that in half, and at 125 watts, that's what it would take to get 50 mega hashes per second. I just don't know that that's going to justify the price for most people. Here's some additional numbers to be aware of on the RTX 3080. I've created a profile here on whattomine.com, and we'll take a look at what the profitability is. Now, for the sake of comparison and keeping things interesting, I've also added some theoretical hash rates for Zhash and for Kryptonite Heavy based on this new ratio of performance versus Ethash and the previous generations of RTX cards. I think that these are probably going to be fairly accurate. We'll see. We'll see what happens in the near future. Cost basis for power at 10 cents and profitability versus difficulty of 7 days. I'm going to go ahead and calculate that so we can see what today's prices are. And as you can see, at the time of recording, Bitcoin is down to 10,300. Ethereum down to nearly $330. A lot of coins are dipping today. So even with that dip, we see that Ethereum is profitable to the tune of about $3.71 per day on 10 cent power. Heck, eGEM, good to see the eGEM team there. They're profitable to the tune of over $1 a day on the 3080. Very interesting to see that with such high performance, even Haven Protocol and other Kryptonite coins could be profitable on this NVIDIA card. That's very rare to see in the NVIDIA GPU mining scene. So kind of interesting data there. But jumping back into the spreadsheet, I've got better numbers there. We may see that the 3090 also, that it goes well above the projected performance of 111 megahashes per second, and it may do so at a much higher power consumption rate than initially perceived, right? If the average was 250 for the 3080, then the 3090 might be even higher at about 275. It is a bit of a beastly card, and we know it's going to consume more power in exchange for the performance that it offers. So the efficiency of these cards might not be what you're looking for. It might just be raw power, but at the expense of higher power consumption. So that has changed on this spreadsheet. Additionally, with this new data that's been obtained thanks to sources like Easy Crypto, I've created a ratio that now allows us to project, right? Essentially to extrapolate from that initial ratio, which is about 71% higher than the RTX 2080 Ti. So extrapolate that across all other algorithms versus the 2080 Ti. And I think that's going to be a safe bet moving forward for now. Until we have better numbers, I think that's going to be a safe bet to just presume that every algorithm will go up by about 70% roughly over the baseline of the 2080 Ti, which is impressive, right? Definitely impressive. However, the power consumption profile, not so much. And I know it's going to adjust quite a bit. Something else to be aware of is that I've adjusted a few other numbers. Among them, the Ethereum mining hash rate of the Polaris Edition cards. Very common to get 32 mega hashes per second out of these cards. It takes, yes, some tweaking, takes some efficiency gains, but it's very, very common. As well as the 5700 and the 5700 XT. Very common to get about 61.5 mega hashes out of the 5700 XT. So that has been changed to reflect real world mining conditions that many miners have reported being able to achieve or their success rate. Now, I've also changed a couple of things here within the 6000 series GPUs announced by AMD. And why did I do that? I did that because of some data from Cortex.tech, as well as their videos. Big Navi Not So Big is the name of their article that talks about the potential for Big Navi not necessarily being the power move that a lot of us believe it could be. It may just be iterative over the 5000 series Radeon cards. And they go over not only that and more in a video called RX 6900 XT Has AMD Been Jabaiting Us All? So I'll link to those in the description of this video. Definitely appreciate some of the points gone over by Cortex in this video. It's very possible that within 2020, we might not see a 6900 XT. So I've reduced those model numbers to 6700 and 6700 XT. So it may be that the top tier card released by AMD this year is actually a 6800, more along the lines of a 6800, and that it's just iteratively improved over other cards that are available right now. Additionally, because these don't use HBM memory, because they use GDDR6 memory, they're very unlikely to achieve, even with the improvements in instructions per cycle, even with die shrinks, even with all of the other tricks that are being pulled out of AMD's sleeve to create a very high performance piece of silicon, because the memory bandwidth may not be as high as the Radeon 7, it's unlikely that the hash rates coming out of these cards will be as high as the Radeon 7. Just in my opinion, this is armchair analysis, take this with a grain of salt. I don't know what the total memory throughput will be versus the amount of compute. Even with additional compute units, it may be that the hash rate is not anything to write home about. However, the hash rate for the amount of power consumed may be very impressive, and we've seen consistent gains from AMD since 2017 moving forward, or 2016 moving forward, with each new product release that AMD has made gains in efficiency for Ethereum mining. So I suspect that's going to be the case here with the 6700. Without changing the power profile, because we don't have data for that yet, I have changed a little bit about what the projected performance could be, placing the 6700 at about 7.5% greater than the 5700 XT, and the 6700 XT at about 15% greater than the 5700 XT. So that's my methodology. You guys, I've laid that bare for you so you know why I made those choices. Everything else where we don't have a lot of data or any leaks to go off of, I've left largely untouched. One other notable exception might be, let's see, nope, no other notable exceptions. Everything else is pretty much untouched. So let's take a look at some of the data. And again, I'm going to use data to help fuel some of these decisions. Going to the ETHASH tab there, going to sort sheet Z to A, and it shows us, it hasn't changed, I already had this sorted from before, that in the top of the list, we've got the Polaris Edition cards by AMD. We've got the GTX 1066 gig, by NVIDIA. We've got the 1050 Ti, which of course will not be able to survive the DAG file growth of Ethereum. It may only be useful for mining Ethash on certain coins, but not Ethereum, and definitely not Ethereum Classic today. And then the 5700 XT, P106, the mining edition part of the essentially the GTX 1060, 5700, P104, and then the projected performance of the 6000 series AMD cards. And then below that, to round off the top 50% of performers, basically everything ending in 60 from Team Green. This is card number 5. And let's take a look at what to mine right now and take a look at anything by NVIDIA ending in 60, essentially. Right now, if you were to get 6 GTX 1060 6 gig cards, you would spend less than picking up an RTX 3080. And we looked at what the RTX 3080 numbers were just a moment ago, at about 135 mega hashes per second on Ethereum. And frankly, at an average power consumption of a little bit less than that, we're going to call that 480 and not 520. Let's go ahead and calculate that. Profitability at 7 days, difficulty at 7 day average, and cost at 10 cents per kilowatt hour. And we're doing over $4, almost $5 of daily profit per day on that configuration, as well as opening up some different performance profiles. We've got privacy coins like Swap, BitTube Cash, and Haven Protocol all earning more than that RTX 3080. Now, can you put a GTX 1060 into your gaming rig and make it awesome? Well, no, you can't. So it is a different value proposition. If you just want to mine on your gaming desktop and you're just looking for a single card upgrade, well then, of course, maybe the 1060 6 gig isn't the right choice for you. So let's wipe the slate clean and go over to a different NVIDIA card ending in 60. We'll start with the 1660 base edition right there. And that actually performs even lower than the 1060 6 gig. So just be aware, there could be a problem there. Let's check out Amazon also and take a look at the 1600 series. Looks like we can get just the 1660 listed right here, and we'll get a sense for what some prices are brand new. Oh, almost $300. Okay, so you're looking at, well, there we go. That's a little more in line with my expectations, $214. Let me grab a calculator really quickly and divide $1,000 by 215, we'll say. Looks like we can get 4 of these cards for the same price as a 3080. So jumping back over into whattomine.com, let's put 4 of these into that same matrix right there. We're under 100 mega hashes and we're doing it about 320 watts. The rest is, it's an interesting value proposition, but let's go ahead and click calculate right now and we'll just see. Well, you know, we're still not doing that bad, but we're not doing as well as we would with the 1060 6 gig, nor are we doing as well as we could with an RTX 3080. And that RTX 3080, of course, doubles as a really fun workhorse in the gaming rig and a really great workhorse in the content creation rig or studio with RTX and any kind of real-time visualization or digital content creation. I don't think that's the best option, but again, anything ending in 60 is going to be probably a better value for your money. Let's look at the 1660 Ti. Now, over on Amazon, we can also, in the NVIDIA store, which you see linked down in the description below, we can pick up the 1660 Ti and figure out what the base numbers are there. Looks like it's not too much more expensive than the 1660 base model. Well, nope, spoke too soon. Looks like it's actually somewhere between $270 and $300 at minimum. Could be somewhere closer to like $290 on average. So again, going to do a quick calculation. I suspect we're only gonna get 3 of these, right? That's how the math works there, right? We're not quite going to get 4 for $1,000. So let's look at 3 of these and see what the total hash rate is there. Even lower. We're even below 80 mega hashes, but we're doing so more efficiently. Go ahead and calculate. I think that's the 1660 Ti's legacy. And we're doing almost similar daily profit because of the efficiency on Ethereum. However, then we're stuck with a 1660 Ti. We're not stuck with anything like an 80 series model, even a 2080 for any other general purpose use like gaming or content creation. That said, a 1660 Ti or a 1660 would be a perfectly valid choice if you were putting together a video editing workstation and you just needed NVENC in order to be able to encode your your videos using NVIDIA's built-in encoder, hardware encoder on the card. These would be perfectly valid options. However, you're not going to get better frame rates or very good frame rates when you're playing games. So as a general purpose GPU part, maybe not so great. Let's look at the 2060 really fast, and then we'll call it a day here on the NVIDIA 60 edition cards. And this is again, the top of the list here. Just the tip of the iceberg, so to speak. All right, so going up to the top of the NVIDIA store, we're gonna go to the 20 series, and let's take a look at the RTX 2060. And we may be in for a treat if we look at the 2060 Super, but it looks like the 2060, yep, priced commensurately, it's over $300. We're not quite gonna even get three of these for $1,000, totaling that purchase of the 3060. So let's say that we're gonna get just two of the 2060s. And there's no 2060 Super listed here on What to Mine. Not too worried about that, but now we're below 60 mega hashes per second at 240 watts. Let's calculate that to see what our daily profit is. And we're below $2 per day on the high end using the 2060 at the same purchase price. So again, if you can't get a 3080 for mining purposes, I personally think looking at anything ending in 60 is a good deal, but you get a heck of a lot more bang for your buck on the GTX 1060 6 gig than you do on any other card from Team Green. Who would have thought? Well, frankly, guys, I'm gonna do a little victory dance here again and say maybe I thought that, but that's because I was using data from day one and I wasn't using my emotions. So that's what the data tells me, is that this is just a better purchase if you're doing this for mining. Resale, that's a whole different ball game. Now the 3000 series from NVIDIA has thrown off the pricing of all the 2000 series from NVIDIA and the 1600 series from NVIDIA, going clear back to the 1000 series from NVIDIA. Resale value has definitely been affected, or will be in the near future. So take that with a grain of salt. But that's on the top of the list there. If you can't get yourself an RTX 3080, again, maybe another valid option would be to consider a Radeon 7. Let's take a look at the Radeon 7 numbers. Now, first off, I've adjusted them to reflect real-world performance. Now, I don't know that I mentioned this before, but I should now. On the data tab, I've also adjusted this to reflect the numbers that Bitsby Trippin has achieved with high stability on his test bench. 92 mega hashes per second is far more in line with some of the real-world testing from good faith actors like Carter. So thank you so much, Carter, for publishing your numbers. Let's take a look at What to Mine. I think I have it listed there as 95. Let's bring it back down to 92. Keep that a little, the kind of temporary expectations there. Hit calculate. All the other numbers are largely unchanged except for Kryptonite Heavy, which was also tested at about 2300 hashes per second. It looks like, yep, there you go. Ethereum, top of the list. 350, but that's not the full story, right? We need to figure out exactly how much this costs. So let's take a look at Radeon graphics cards here within the AMD store on, oh, you know what? We can't even find Radeon 7 within the AMD store. And I think that's because Radeon 7 is extremely rare. It was a limited edition part, or was supposed to be a limited edition part. Right here within Amazon, at least, the only Radeon 7 part that is available is the reference card. The reference design, here we go, from XFX, this one. So looks like, oh, used. These are selling for over $1,200. Let's hit up eBay to see what the story is there. And it looks like, again, with eBay, I'm gonna use completed items only. I don't want to lead you astray here. 780, 765, $800, 730, 800, 900, 710, almost 850, 850, 750, 850. I've seen a lot of prices over 800. This one, somebody here got a deal. Nobody else is getting these for under $700. Almost everybody else is getting them for over $800 and paying upwards of $1,000 plus for their Radeon 7. Yikes. Okay, so basically, you're paying about the same for roughly the same performance as the 3080 on mining, and frankly, probably not the same performance on gaming, and definitely no ray tracing in your games. Maybe this will be helpful to you as a content creator because it has 16 gigs of RAM, but the Radeon 7, well, it's a poor consolation prize for not being able to get an RTX 3080. So, top half of the list, anything ending in 60. And I'm going to say top of that list is the GTX 1060. And then a close second would be that 1660, not the Ti and not the 2060, but the 1660, because you get more bang for your buck. However, GTX 1060 is the top of that list. And then hot on its heels is the 5700 XT. Again, looking at the data, The data tells me in hash per dollar per watt that outside of the Polaris Edition cards, the 5700 XT is really good to have. Really, really good to have. So let's take a look at what that performance looks like on whattomine.com and take a look at pricing right now. Back in the AMD store on Amazon, we're going to use this as a baseline for pricing. And you may be saying, but Seth, I can find it cheaper somewhere else. And I will respond, but my friend, on average, and if you want to get this delivered quickly, these are the prices you will pay. You and I both know it's true. So let's take a look at the 5700 XT. You may also be wondering, Seth, why no 5600 XT? Why no 5500 XT? The 5500 XT has proven not to be really that great. The 5600 XT, yes, is highly efficient, but I don't have good numbers for it, so I will add that at some point in the future. Thank you for your patience. All right, so almost $500. Let's take a look at some other prices right now. Just under $400. Not bad right there, the $390 for the MSI Gaming, but a lot of others that are over $400. I think that we are in good shape when we say the average is about $400. So $390, all the way up to, I mean, yeah, wow. Wow, some, they're also miscategorized. That might be a Radeon 56, but geez, the thick there at almost $700. Another XT for $450. I think $400 is a good price to be able to pay for the 5700 XT. And if you can get it for less than that used, then awesome. That's just great. And it's not entirely useless for gaming, but it's definitely no, it's no RTX card. It's no ray tracing card. And if that's what you're looking forward to in gaming or some kind of, what is it? The new art, is it RDNA? Is that the new model for gaming? He says in out of touch ease. All right. So yes, this is definitely going to be good for content creators though. So it looks pretty obvious to me. We're only going to get about two of these for the same price as an RTX 3080. But for that price, we're getting over the 100 mega hash mark. And again, same variables below, same profitability, same cost. Hit that solve button. And is it possible we're going to get higher performance? Yes. Again, on the data tab, we know that the 5700 XT is capable of 61.5 mega hashes per second. Let me go ahead and correct that on this sheet. We should be getting about 122, we'll say. Maybe 122 and change. So solve again. And now we've got profitability, boom, at the $4.57 mark. That is some great hash per dollar. That's some great profitability per dollar. And this is a reasonably performant workstation card and gaming card. However, again, no ray tracing. That's up to you deciding if that's important to you or not for your resale plans later on. But this could definitely become the workstation replacement for other GPU users in the future if you're looking at reselling. All right, so the 5700 XT is on the list in spot number three as a consolation prize if you're not getting the 3080. Let's take a look at some of our other data and what it indicates to us. What we're going to say is instead of the Polaris Edition cards, any mining edition card. I know. Resale value? Be darned. We're not going to be worrying about resale value right now. But let's take a look at the AMD or the NVIDIA mining edition cards. And specifically, let's take a look at P106. P106-100 because you can most easily find that in a 6 GB configuration. All right, we've got for our sold purchases here. This is on the parts only, bummer. But here, 117, 142, 119, 150 passively cooled, 115. We've got so many, there you go, almost $100, not for parts, totally working, totally functioning. $100 there, $100 there. Wow, okay, 119 working. With shipping, it looks like we're spending about $120 to $130. That really does change the value proposition a lot. So let's go over what to mine. We'll go back, the nearest data that we have for that, oops, is gonna be back over here on the 1060 6 gig. It's actually gonna be our closest comparison right there. Let's go ahead and grab that $1,000 mark and divide it by 130. That gives us the option to throw 7 cards into a rig at the same price as a 3080. Calculating that, and now with a hash rate of over 157, we've got over $5 in daily profit. So that's your card number two. Definitely more profitable than an RTX 3080, however, entirely useless for any kind of desktop GPU purpose. So take that with a grain of salt. and one final entry into the top GPUs that you can buy as a consolation prize for not being able to get your hands on an RTX 3080, and that is any Polaris Edition card, but specifically the 580 8GB. And let's take a look on Amazon to see if we can find any kind of RX 580 8GB card. So 8GB, and we're looking at between $180 and $200 for those brand new here, but you can get them brand new in box for $179 shipped, or check it out, ooh, $570, which can be flashed to look like the 580. So basically anything between the $470 up to the $580 with 8GB is valid here. If we can find a $470 and a desktop version, then this is totally valid. $160, that's unreal. $160 shipped free with Prime 2-day shipping. That's a pretty spanking deal. Another power color as well. It looks like that is only a 4GB card though, but we definitely want 8GB cards here. Let's take a look on eBay as well. So we'll look up the RX 570 8GB. Let's see what we can find. We got $140, $105. Oh my gosh, that's awesome. Asus ROG Strix. We've got MSI. We've got Sapphire. Nice. This is not the mining edition card, but it is 4GB. We've got 8GB here for $122. Another Sapphire Radeon. We've got some that are, I think these are more the exception than the rule to be up closer to $200, but it looks like we're with free shipping, we get it for $150 and a little bit below that. Again, very similar to the 1060 in terms of the value proposition, we're looking at about $140 roughly, not $130, but $140. So let me go ahead and take that calculator up again, and let's divide our $1,000 purchase price by 140. And again, that's still going to divide in by 7 times. So taking a look at whattomine.com and replacing every other value with the 570. So 570, same power basis, same cost for power and everything else. We're looking at $6.47 per day. And we have the option of Ravencoin, as well as Beam and several others, Haven Protocol and others that are still in profitability when we look at that style of card. Pretty much, I mean, this is unreal, guys. This is practically the Holy Grail, the mining edition cards. And who would have thought Polaris edition cards would still be the king of mining, even with HBM2 options out there in terms of hash per dollar per watt. And again, I'm urging you to take this very seriously, because this is where miners live and or die, is in these margins of how much they spend to get started if they're acquiring more cards versus how much they spend on electricity versus how efficiently those cards mine. All right, I hope this has been helpful to you. If you haven't already gotten your free copy of this spreadsheet, feel free to hit up the link below to the article on mineyour.biz. Definitely click notifications so you know when new videos like this come out. If you think that we've merited that subscription, of course, then that means a whole lot. Thank you for the thumbs up as well. And thank you for joining our new email list. That's right, our email notification list. So you'll be notified when high impact videos like this come out, as opposed to our interviews and some of our developer chats and the other talks that we have on the channel. If you want to be notified of just mining news, just mining conversations, then go ahead and hit up that email list. It would mean a lot to us and validate that what we're doing is the right thing. And we'll also be able to give you special deals, let you know when special deals are coming out. And as we work on our GPU deal finder algorithm, we'll be able to alert you at no cost. So thank you again. You're the reason I make this media. I love your face, and I will see you in the next one.